So with that being said, let's begin. What I want to show you, what our brother Jared found in Jeremiah 15, is he was showing that, you know, it coincides with what we're talking about as far as the destructions coming upon Jerusalem. Now, remember what we showed in what I just showed you on our timeline and what it shows in Daniel 9? They're always talking about the destruction of Jerusalem. You know, everyone's been looking at these scriptures, and every time they see the word Jerusalem, you know, subconsciously in your mind, you know, we make it out to be Israel. We always say Israel, Israel's 70th year. Oh, and the people are saying, oh, it's Israel turned 71 or Israel turned 72. Some say, oh, Israel's already 73. But when you read the scriptures carefully, they don't say Israel. They say Jerusalem. And that's why I just showed you that it's Jerusalem that it's about to complete its 70th year. And so we need to stay focused on what the scriptures are actually saying. They're talking about the destruction of Jerusalem before their 70th year ends. And that's what we're going to kind of get into here. And we're going to build on this and see how it leads up to the greater part of our teaching today. So when you read Jeremiah 15:15, what does it say? For who shall have pity upon thee, O Jerusalem? Have pity upon Jerusalem. Or who shall bemoan thee? Or who shall go aside to ask how thou doest? And what happens? In 15:16, the Lord says, thou hast forsaken me, saith the Lord. Okay? Thou art gone backward. Therefore, I will stretch out my hand against thee and destroy thee. I am weary with repenting. And I will fan them with a fan in the gates of the land. I will bereave them of children. I will destroy my people since they return not from their ways. You see, the Lord God is talking about the destruction. The destroying, I will destroy my people since they return not from their ways. And what's he talking about? Jerusalem. Let's be clear about what the Lord's talking about. Jerusalem. He doesn't say Israel. Is it possible that Israel also gets destroyed in the process? Yes. I can't say no. But very specifically, they're referring to Jerusalem. And what does he say? I have caused him to fall upon it suddenly in terrors upon the city. Terrors upon the city. What city? Jerusalem. Do you see that? Over and over and over again in the scriptures, they're continually talking about the city of Jerusalem being destroyed. And look at this part in 15:9. Her sun is gone down while it was yet day. So during the daytime, the sun goes down. And what's he saying? I will deliver the sword before their enemies, saith the Lord. He's talking about a destruction, a sword coming to Jerusalem during a daytime when the sun will go down. And how does this fit into the greater part of the stories we're going to go into? Well, let's build on that. let's go into Amos. And Amos chapter 8:9. And what does Amos say? It sounds very similar to what we just read in Jeremiah. And it shall come to pass that in that day, saith the Lord God, that I will cause the sun to go down at noon. See, again, the sun's going down earlier than it should be. And I will darken the earth in the clear day. And I will turn your feasts into mourning. Now, this is the important part. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land. What famine is he talking about? Not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but of hearing the words of the Lord. It's a famine for hearing the words of the Lord. And we're going to see how this connects into some more of Jeremiah and Daniel 9. There's a famine for hearing the words of the Lord. Remember this. And they shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord and shall not find it. So what's going on in the land? Some of us have read about the famine in Jeremiah 52. and thought perhaps it was a famine of bread or water or so on and so forth. But he's talking about it's a famine of hearing the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord has been removed and is not heard throughout the land. Let's go back to Jeremiah. Jeremiah 52. Let's go to Jeremiah 52, 6. And in the fourth month, in the ninth day of the month, the famine was sore. Where? In the city. Remember what we just read in Jeremiah 15 when he was talking about the city? It was the city of what? Jerusalem. Here it is again. And he and his army and he in Babylon, Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came, he and all his army, against Jerusalem and pitched against it. And what does it say in 52:6 again? In the fourth month, in the ninth day of the month, the famine, the word of the Lord, was sore in the city of Jerusalem. And what does it say in 52:7? The city was broken up. And all the men of war fled and went forth from the city. Let's take a look, close look at this fourth month and ninth day on our Enoch calendar that we made. We kind of went over this in one of our prior videos, but I just want to show everyone again what this looks like and why we're talking about it. When he's talking about the fourth month and ninth day, that was on July the 29th. July 29th, right? On the Enoch calendar, it's the fourth month, ninth day, July 29th. And when we go all the way across over to here, what does it come to? The 52nd book of Jeremiah. And how did we line that up? Remember how we lined it up in our prior, not prior video, but one of our first videos we put out? There's that prophecy of Daniel 9. Remember the prophecy of Daniel 9 that we talked about? Let's kind of just go through that real quickly and just show everybody what that prophecy is about. What does Daniel say in Daniel 9? Daniel says, in the first year of his reign, I, Daniel, understood by the books the number of years whereof the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah. Weren't we just reading in Jeremiah? And he's talking about the famine in the land. No one's hearing the word of God in the land. That's the famine he's talking about. But what is Daniel saying? That he understood the books, the number of years, and these are the books of Jeremiah, that he would accomplish 70 years in the desolations of Jerusalem. Remember we said desolations is the destruction. The destruction of Jerusalem. So it's very clear in Daniel 9, too, that he's saying that we can figure out the 70 years to the destruction of Jerusalem by looking at the number of books of Jeremiah. So if we look at the number of books of Jeremiah, we should know when the 70 years to the destruction of Jerusalem comes. So let's take a look at that. What happened? Well, when you take a close look at what happened on June 6th, this date that we're looking at, June 7th, what happened on that date? We talked about this before. I'll go over it kind of briefly now so we can all see it. But what happened on that date when we look at it? What happened is when you go to, scroll down a little bit more. So on June 7th, 1967, there was the Six-Day War in Jerusalem. And Israel won back Jerusalem on June 7th, 1967. So when you add 52 years, remember Daniel said he understood by the books the number of years. When you add 52 years to 1967, it brings you to June 7th, 2019. But that's the beginning of 52 years. When does Jerusalem complete 52 years? They'll complete 52 years on June 7th, 2020. That's when they'll complete the 52 years. So this part of the prophecy, the 52 books, the 52 years, has already taken place. This prophecy, we've all lived through this prophecy coming true on June 7th, 2020, where the Daniel 9, part of the Daniel 9:2 prophecy has already happened. It's occurred. That's the 52-year part. But what about the 70-year part? What about the 70 years of Jerusalem? Remember we showed it at the beginning of this video where Israel declared Jerusalem their capital in 1915. And when you count 70 years, that's what? That's also 2020. So the 52 years are completed on June 7th, 2020. And what did we show earlier? The 70 years will be completed on January 23rd, 2021. So June 7th, Jerusalem completed that portion of their 52 years of the Daniel prophecy for their 52 years. And then Jerusalem will also complete their 70th year on January 23rd, 2021. So that's why this is our last high watch date. Jerusalem will be destroyed before January 23rd, 2021, while they're still in their 70th year, because that's what the prophecies tell us. And so what else is going on here about this June 7th date? Well, remember how we counted 52 years to get to this date from June 7th, 1967? This ends the 52 years. What about the 52 books of Jeremiah? He told us by the number of books of Jeremiah, right? So let's count the books as if they were days. When you count down this column of the books of Jeremiah, all 52 books, as if they were the days of Jeremiah, the 52 days, where does the 52nd book end? It ends exactly where Jeremiah 52:6 tells us, fourth month, ninth day. Isn't that what we just read? Isn't that what we just read in Jeremiah? Let's take a look at that again. When we go to Jeremiah 52:6, what does it say? Fourth month, ninth day of the month, the famine was sore in the city. On the fourth month, ninth day, the famine was sore in the city. When was that date? Is that shocking and amazing that when we count 52 days as books, 52 days from when Jerusalem completed 52 years, they completed their 52 years on June 7th. And when you count 52 more days as the books, like Daniel said, it brings us to exactly the date on the Enoch calendar of the fourth month, ninth day, just like the scripture says. And when was that date? It was July 29th. That's the 52 days. And what's more shocking? Remember how we did this in our previous, in our first video that we did? When you now count from this July 29th date, and now you count the 150 days. Remember we found that 150 day pattern throughout scriptures? Now let's count the 150 days from this date that Jeremiah gave us. Jeremiah gave us the fourth month, ninth day in Jeremiah 52:6. Now let's count the 150 days in this column and let's see where that brings us to. The 150th day is when? The 10th of Tevet. And why is that important? Watch this. What does Jeremiah tell us? Let's go back to what he says in the first part of this chapter. And it came to pass in the ninth year of his reign, in the 10th month, in the 10th day of the month, that Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, he and all his army came against who? Jerusalem, and pitched against it. 10th month, 10th day. 10th month, 10th day, the exact 150th day from the first day that Jeremiah gave us is the 10th of Tevet, just like he says in scripture. And when is that? December 25th. And what's the first high watch date that we've been telling everybody about? December 25th, the 150th day. This is why, brothers and sisters, this is our very, very first high watch date. Do you see how we got that? Jeremiah gave us the first date, as Daniel told us, as the 52 books of Jeremiah. And that date, fourth month, ninth day, Jeremiah gave us this date. It fell here. And when you count the 52 books, that is the date that Jeremiah gave us. And now from that date, you count another 150 days. And it gives us the last date that Jeremiah gave us, and this is the last date he gave us was the 10th of Tevet, and that ends on December 25th. And this is why, brothers and sisters, this is why this is our first high watch date. And there's several other reasons, and those further reasons are taught in our prior videos. So if you want to get more clarity and details of why else this is our first high watch date, please look at our other videos, especially the first and second one that we made. It goes into great detail. And then we have our ending date. We just showed you why. Because on January 23rd, Jerusalem, not Israel, Jerusalem will complete and have fulfilled their 70th year. So their destruction, as we showed in Daniel 9, the destruction of Jerusalem must come sometime after December 25th, like Jeremiah just showed us, and just prior to January 23rd, when Jerusalem will have completed their 70 years. And I want to thank our brother Jared so much for showing this to us, for bringing these truths out in the scriptures, and for being so diligent in his studies. Brother Jared, I can't thank you enough. Amazing finds, and I really appreciate all you've been doing in this ministry. God bless you always, Brother Jared. Thank you so much.